I went for trekking on the mountains. There I saw a big cave. I entered that cave to explore. After a few yards, the cave had a very narrow passage before getting wider again. I tried to enter that passage but got trapped between the two rocks. I tried to move back and forth but could not. With nobody to help, I panicked. I started perspiring. My heart started pounding. My body started freezing. Then suddenly, gathering all the power in my body, with a final push, I snapped out from my dream. Oof, it was a nightmare. I looked at the wall clock. It was 1 a.m. midnight. I tried to sleep, but could not till 5 in the morning. I felt intense fear, got restless, and started moving. After I slept, I got up in the morning. I was perfectly all right. Good evening, Madam Toastmaster, my fellow Toastmasters, and esteemed guests. Similar nightmares started haunting me quite often, wherein I was trapped somewhere, woke up during the night, and started to work. Finally, about a year ago, in January 2019, I could not sleep for 3 days consecutively. I could not lie on the bed or sit on the chair. I had an urge to move continuously even during the day. I was helpless, sleepless, clueless. I was so depressed that I thought my days were numbered and I was going to die soon. With tears in my eyes, I told my wife in a choked voice, "If I suffer a stroke, please do not put me on the ventilator. I should be allowed to leave the world peacefully. Also, note down the details of my investments so that you do not have any problem after my death." After that, I consulted a neurologist at Namcare Hospital. I was diagnosed to be suffering from akathisia. Akathisia is a state of mental agitation with an urgent need to move. It has panic, anxiety, impatience, and irritability as its symptoms. I told the doctor that I am having fear of confined places, I am afraid to stay alone at house, and I am developing suicidal tendencies. After the checkup, I went to one of the directors of Namcare Hospital who is known to me. I told him, "You have always helped me. Now I am developing suicidal tendencies. Please save me. I want to be cured." He talked to the neurologist over phone and then said, "Don't worry, you will be perfectly alright soon." The doctor gave me tablets for antidepressant tablets. I could half sleep that day, and by third day I could sleep properly. I consumed those tablets for 4 months continuously and again became in the pink of my health. The medicines which the doctor gave me was to increase the level of serotonin in the brain. Serotonin is a chemical which is called happy chemical because of its ability to give us happiness, cheerfulness, and calmness. It makes us feel at peace, focused, and emotionally stable. If we have proper level of serotonin in our brain, we feel happy. throughout my life, I had believed that whether we lead a happy life or miserable life is determined by our past life karma. Some people say happiness is an attitude, not a condition of life. But at the age of 60, I got enlightenment and discovered the real secret of happiness. So if you want to remain happy, forget about past life karma or attitude towards life, take care of your serotonin. Serotonin can be increased by three ways. One, proper diet. If you eat eggs, cheese, salmon, tofu, nuts, pineapple, banana, and dark green leafy vegetables, serotonin level increases. Regular exercise also increases the level of serotonin. Similarly, sunshine also increases the serotonin level. My dear friends, now you also know the real secret of happiness. So if you want to remain happy, take proper care of your serotonin. Even after that, if you are not happy, consult your physician or Dr. Simando for advice. Thank you very much.